एनर्जी एंड पावर पार्ट 5 इज अ कोलिजन. कोलिजन मीन्स द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन टू बॉडीज ड्यू टू विच डायरेक्शन एंड मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द कोलाइडिंग बॉडीज चेंजेस. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द कोलिजन. हियर इन द केस ऑफ द कोलिजन एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज आर नेग्लेक्टेड. देर आर 3 टाइप्स ऑफ कोलिजन: परफेक्टली इलास्टिक कोलिजन, इनइलास्टिक कोलिजन एंड परफेक्टली इनइलास्टिक कोलिजन. Perfectly elastic collision. In this first one, perfectly elastic collision, linear momentum and kinetic energy both are conserved, means both remain same. However, if we are talking about this first one, that practically it is not possible. That is in fact impractical. Perfectly it is not possible. Say for example, one object is falling, one ball is falling onto the surface, here the surface, then after rebound it is not reaching to this particular height. No, not possible. Some energy is being lost, so definitely the real situation is like that, it will rebound to a certain height. Certain height means both the heights are not same, some energy is being lost. That is the real situation. So it is you can say the perfectly elastic collision is an impractical or ideal. Number two is the inelastic collision. Inelastic collision is a collision in which the linear momentum remains conserved but kinetic energy not conserved. Kinetic energy not conserved. Some loss of the energy. That is the practical situation. And third one is a perfectly inelastic collision, where the two bodies are moving and stick together and move as one body. In this case, linear momentum conserved and but kinetic energy not conserved. In all the three cases, you remember that total energy remains conserved. In all cases, all collisions. So, in case of a perfectly inelastic collision, the example of the perfectly inelastic collision, that say for example one bullet is there and one bullet is fired on a say wooden plank is there. Here wooden plank. This bullet is strike it here and it will reach inside, it pierce inside and then it moves along with the wooden block and the bullet, both are start moving, it stick together and it will move as one body only, then we can say perfectly inelastic collision. So these are the fundamentals of the collision. Now we come on to the elastic collision in one dimension and two dimension. Elastic collision in one dimension. Here the two objects I have taken, say this is M1 and M2, both are moving in this way in one dimension only. It is having the mass M1, it is M2, and the first one is having initial velocity U1, second one U2. And after collision, it is going to collide. Why it is going to collide? Because U1 is greater than U2. It is collide. And after collision, again it will start moving in the same direction. Direction is not going to change because we are talking about the one dimension motion only. So mathematically, how we are going to show it? Just see the two objects, A and B, two balls. We have taken A, B, this initial, and here the collision occurs. And after collision, again the only the speed is going to change, V1 and V2, that is the final speed. So in case of the elastic collision, we know that linear momentum conserved. That we know. And kinetic energy also conserved. That is the case. So when the linear momentum conserved, we have to say that Pi is equal to Pf, means initial total linear momentum is equal to final total linear momentum. So linear momentum, you know, the mass into velocity initial. So it is here m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Right? This is your linear momentum. And as the kinetic energy is also conserved, so we have to write it here. Kinetic energy means initial is equal to kinetic energy final of the system. System is having the two balls. So we can write it half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Right? Now just you see, we can take, so from this equation we can write it here m1 u1 minus v1 is equal to m2 v2 minus u2. This we can write, give it equation number 1. We have taken here m1, here m1, so taken common from this side. Similarly here half half going to be cancelled. So m1 u1 square minus v1 square is equal to m2 v2 square minus u2 square. Give it equation number 2. These two equations are there. This equation we can write m1 a minus b a one a square minus b square u1 plus v1 u1 minus v1 is equal to m2 v2 plus u2, and here it is v2 minus u2. This one. Now, give it equation number 3. Now, just to see equation 1 and equation 2, just to see how to make it short. Our purpose is to make it short and find the final velocity v1, v2 like that. So, how to make it short? Only one thing, if we are going to divide number 3 by 1, then it is easier. Equation 3 divide by 1. If we are going to divide this by this, so we can write it here. After dividing, what happens is m1 is going to cancel. U1 minus V1, that is going to be cancelled, only leaving behind this one. And similarly, this divide by this means M2 cancelled, V2 minus U2 is going to cancel, only leaving behind this. So after dividing, we can get easily U1 plus V1 is equal to V2 plus U2, or U1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. That is the important aspect, important relation number 4. Here U1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. This is known as relative, this one left hand side u1 minus u2, relative velocity of approach. That should be equal to, and this is known as relative velocity of separation. Relative velocity of separation. That relative velocity of approach is equal to relative velocity of separation. Now, this equation, this by this is not particular different thing, but rather the constant known as coefficient of restitution. So here one ratio is there, E, that is the coefficient of restitution. Is equal to v2 minus v1 by u1 minus u2. Means this is what velocity of separation, relative velocity of separation, and this is what relative velocity of approach. The ratio of this is known as the coefficient of restitution. For perfectly elastic collision, this E is having one value, right? Now we have to find the velocities after collision. Now our purpose is to find the, in this particular topic only, velocities after collision. Means we have to find out V1 and V2. Only substitution is there. So how to find it? We know V2 is equal to U1 minus U2 plus V1. We can write it from this equation number 4. V2 is equal to this plus this, this one. Put this value. We have to write, put this value in above equation, and equation 2 most probably, that was which equation we are talking about, M1 U1 minus V1 is equal to M2 V2 minus U2. That was the equation. So put this value V2 in this equation. So we will get after putting and solving in this particular in this equation the value of V2 in place of this only V2. Put this value and you will get the result. Result will be V1 is equal to 2 M2 U2 plus U1 M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2. This you will get it, the value of V1. Similarly, this we require. Similarly, if we are putting the value of V1 from equation number 4 in the same equation, if you are putting the value of V1 from this equation in this, then we will get the V2, value of the V2. So, similarly, V1, putting the value of V1 from 4 in, better to write the in the which equation, in that equation in numbering is most probably 2 or 3 in m1 u1 minus v1 is equal to m2 v2 minus u2. If we are putting the value of v1 in this equation, we will get what? We will get the value v2 is equal to 2m1 u1 plus u2 m2 minus m1 by m1 plus m2. M1 plus m2. This is clear, I think. M1 plus m2. This is the value of v2. And this is the value of v1. That the particular part we have to find out. Usually the question is being asked.
Sure.
So v1, it is better to give the name or the equation number 5, and this is the equation number 6. Now special cases, before coming out of special cases, we have find the value of v1 and v2, that is the velocity after the collision. Now special cases, if m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m, then v1 becomes, put in the value, m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m, put in the value, you will get 2m u2 by twice m, that is u2. And v1, we get this one, and v2, we will get u1. That's interesting. Putting the value in the equation 5 and 6 only to find the value of v1 and v2, you will get this much. If m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m, we have taken both are having the same mass, then v1 becomes u2 and v2 becomes u1. So we can conclude that velocities are interchanged after collision. When the both the object is having the same mass, velocities are interchanged. This iska velocity ye le liya, iska ye, is tarah se just interchange. Case number 2, if u2 is equal to 0 and b is initially u2 is equal to 0 means object b is initially at rest, means second object is at rest and first one is moving towards the b. This is rest, not moving. So in this case, we can get v1 from that equation number 5 and 6. We will get v1 is equal to u1 m1 minus m2 by m1 plus m2, and v2 is equal to 2m1 u1 by m1 plus m2. This two equation will get, when this is a condition, when u2 is equal to 0, then we are getting this particular value expression. Okay, coefficient of distribution and its expression. We know coefficient of distribution, relative velocity of separation by relative velocity of approach, that we know. Now how to find the expression? We have assumed one situation, one two balls are there, one little bit bigger, m capital M is greater than small m. another ball is here. I am going to keep it here. And situation is like that, ये ball इसको जाके hit करेगी. ये M जो है ये वाली ball इसको जाके hit करेगी. तो होगा क्या, ये वाली ball फिर ऐसे ऐसे आके बाउंड रिबाउंड होके कुछ दूर तक पहुंची और ये बॉल भी कुछ दूर तक गई. सिचुएशन ऐसा, ये हेवियर बॉल है, लाइटर बॉल है. फिर से देखिए, ये बॉल जाके ऐसे स्ट्राइक करेगा, ये रेस्ट में है इनिशियली, ये रेस्ट में है, जाके स्ट्राइक करेंगे. तो उसके बाद स्ट्राइक होने के बाद यही वाली बॉल कुछ ऊपर तक आई और ये बॉल भी डिस्प्लेस हो गई कुछ सर्टेन हाइट. ये रेफरेंस लाइन है. ओके, तो हम लोग इसको ऐसा एज्यूम करते हैं, यहाँ पर ये बॉल इस जो आ रही है ऐसे, उसका स्पीड है u1 और ये किस हाइट से, h हाइट से लेके चल रहा है. h हाइट से ये बॉल नीचे गिर रही है, ये रेफरेंस लाइन है. अब उसके बाद ये स्ट्राइक होने के बाद हुआ क्या, यही वाली बॉल ऐसे करके स्ट्राइक किए एंड उसके बाद फिर रिबाउंड होके कुछ यहां तक नहीं पहुंची बॉल, मान लेते हैं यहां तक पहुंची. तो ये भी एक पर्टिकुलर वेलोसिटी से ऐसे यहां पहुंची और ये हाइट भी हम लोग ऐसे, और ये वाला बॉल, ये जो बॉल थी ये भी डिस्प्लेस हुआ था कुछ पॉइंट पर यहां पर. तो मान लेते हैं ये सब हाइट भी हम एज्यूम कर लेते हैं. तो ये h2 हाइट तक गई बॉल और इसका ये है h1. ये इनिशियली रेस्ट में था, ये u1 स्पीड से ऐसे, और ये जो स्पीड, ये बॉल जो वापस रिबाउंड आई है उसका स्पीड हम लोग लेके चल रहे हैं v1 फाइनल आफ्टर कोलिजन इससे हुआ, रिबाउंड हुआ, इसका v1 स्पीड किसका, इसका, और इसका स्पीड जिस स्पीड से यहां गया उसका स्पीड हम लोग लेते हैं v2. राइट, सिचुएशन एकदम क्लियर होना चाहिए. अब हम लोग कैसे इसको, ये कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन निकालेंगे. हम लोग यहाँ पर एक फॉर्मूला है, v² = u² + 2gh. हम लोग जानते हैं वेलोसिटी निकालने के लिए अगर u 0 है तो ये √2gh हो जाएगा. ये हम लोग जानते हैं, सिंपल. इनिशियली एट रेस्ट u = 0 का केस लेके हम लोग अगर अप्लाई करेंगे तो यहाँ पर हमारा क्या क्या निकल रहा है. इसका स्पीड इनिशियली u 0 है, राइट, क्लियर. ये 0 है तो हमको यहाँ पर u1 कितना हो गया, 2gh, ये u1 किस स्पीड से आया इतना, राइट. v1 कितना हो गया, v1 इधर वाला v1 कितना हो गया, 2gh1 अंडर रूट, और v2 कितना हो गया, 2gh2 अंडर रूट इतना हो गया. तो हमको e का वैल्यू निकालना था. e का वैल्यू क्या होता है, v2 - v1 / u1 - u2. तो ये सब का वैल्यू पुट कर देंगे, दिस और u2 कितना है, 0 है, तो में कितना आ जाएगा, 2gh2 अंडर रूट माइनस v1 का है 2gh1 अंडर रूट बाय u1 कितना आया था, 2gh माइनस 0. तो अल्टीमेटली मेरा e का वैल्यू कितना निकल रहा है, हम क्या देख रहे हैं नीचे, यहाँ पर सब जगह 2g अंडर रूट 2g है, वो निकल जाएगा अंडर रूट h2 माइनस अंडर रूट h1 बाय अंडर रूट h. ऐसे हम लोग ये एक्सप्रेशन से हम लोग कोफिशिएंट ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन निकालते हैं. दिस इज द वे हाउ टू फाइंड इट. नाउ कम्स द इनइलास्टिक कोलिजन इन वन डायमेंशन. इन वन डायमेंशन इनइलास्टिक कोलिजन इन विच काइनेटिक एनर्जी नॉट कंजर्व्ड, लीनियर मोमेंटम कंजर्व्ड. नाउ इमेजिन द टू सिचुएशन इन ए एंड बी, टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर देयर, A, B is at rest and initially and A is striking with a speed u1 onto the B. Collision, before collision and then after collision, and then what happens, both object become one and moves in the same dimension with a common velocity v. Then we have to apply linear momentum initial m1 this is your m2, this is what m1, this is m2 mass. Initial linear momentum m1 u1 plus m2 into zero, because this is a rest, so ultimately m1 u1. Final linear momentum total, how much it is? m1 plus m2. Why? Because both becomes one, and just like one object it start moving in this. So ultimately from this, v1, these two are equal, principle of conservation linear momentum. So m1 u1 is equal to m1 plus m2 into v. So v is equal to m1 u1 by m1 plus m2. Give it equation number 1. Now kinetic energy initial half m1 u1 square plus u2 is 0, no need to write. The kinetic energy final is equal to half both object combined m1 m2 into v square. Give it equation number 2. Right now, this kinetic energy final by kinetic energy initial, we are just dividing it, final by initial. So we will get m1 by if you are dividing it this by this, so how much it will be? You will get m1 plus m2. Here it is m1 square u1 square by m1 plus m2 whole square by m1 u1 square. Now tell me how we are getting this m1 plus m2, how I have written this one v square. We are putting the value from v from 1 and putting the value here. V is having value m1 u1 by m1 plus m2. This value we have to place it here. Iska value yahan par place ki hai, and then ultimately we'll get, ultimately after calculation we'll get m1 by m1 plus m2, or kinetic energy final is equal to m1 by m1 plus m2 into kinetic energy initial. Right, important relation. Now give it equation number 2. First I had given this 2. Now see it here. Since m1 plus m2 is greater than m1, so we can write kinetic energy final by kinetic energy initial is less than 1, or kinetic energy final is less than kinetic energy initial. So, what is the conclusion? Kinetic energy of the body is after the collision is less than the kinetic energy of the body is before the collision. So, kinetic energy is not conserved. So, kinetic energy not conserved. So, the conclusion is very clear. Kinetic energy is not conserved. Means, initial kinetic energy is having greater than the final one. So, the loss of kinetic energy, loss in kinetic energy will be kinetic energy initial minus M1 by M1 plus M2 into kinetic energy initial. How we are getting it? The value of kinetic energy final, this one, this value we have to put it here, or you can write it. If you are having any kind of confusion, so it is better to write it kinetic energy initial minus kinetic energy final. Kinetic energy initial minus kinetic energy final, the value I am putting it here, M1 by M1 plus M2 into kinetic energy initial. Same value I am keeping it here. So same thing is there. So ultimately its value will be M2 by M1 plus M2 kinetic energy initial. Kinetic energy initial we know, half M1 U1 square, put its value. That kinetic energy initial, that we know, so put its value. So ultimately you will get it M2 by M1 plus M2 into half M1 U1 square. That is your expression. Now arrange it, M1 M2 U1 square by twice M1 plus M2. That is the loss of kinetic energy. That is the expression, important expression. Now collision in the two dimension. We have assumed A and B, two balls are there. B is initially at rest and A, ball A is moving with the u1 velocity, it strikes on B, and as a two dimension is there, so what happens, we are going to assume the first ball A deflect in this direction after collision and B deflect in this direction. So that two dimensional deflection is there, right? A and B, two dimension, and A is making certain angle theta 1 with the x axis, and B ball is deflected, the velocity of B is along the this direction V2, which is making an angle theta 2 with the x axis. So this velocity is going to resolve into two components. So this component becomes V1 cos theta 1, and this one V1 sin theta 1. And similarly this one V2 cos theta 2, and this one will be V2 sin theta 2. Right? This is the situation. Just try to see it once. Very clear it should be. So theta 1 is what? Theta 1 here we are calling it deflecting angle. Deflecting angle or scattering angle. Scattering angle. And theta 2 is known as angle of recoil. Angle of recoil. So this is before collision and this is after collision. This is the situation. only velocity is going to be resolved. Now just to see the calculation part, all this type of collision, the momentum is conserved. Linear momentum is conserved along x and y direction. X and y direction. Right? So, what we are going to write? First equation, m1 u1 is equal to m1 v1 cos theta 1 plus m2 v2 cos theta 2. That is equation number 1. Second equation, you will get 0 for the second one. The object is at rest. 0 is equal to m1 v1 sine theta 1 minus m2 v2 sine theta 2. Now here, interesting, why minus? Just to see, one velocity is along the y direction. One is this direction, positive x, positive y, and this is your negative y. So net is your this much, and initially there is no y component, so that's why zero. Here this is along the x axis. This we are talking about along x axis, and this along y axis. These are the equations which are important to find the different situation. Another, as kinetic energy is conserved in perfectly elastic collision. If the collision is perfectly elastic, we can write it half m1 u1 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 say v square. V1 and V2 we have taken, so V2 square. This is equation number 3rd by taking the consideration of the kinetic energy. Here, by taking the consideration of the momentum. So, by taking these three equation 1, 2 and 3, what are the important points? We have, if we are going to assume M1, M2 and U1 are known, then the motion after collision involves four unknown quantities, V1, V2, theta 1, theta 2. So, whatever the things we require, we can easily find out the other quantities. So, by using 1, 2 and 3. Only these three equations are important for collision in two dimension. Okay. Thank you.